I bet most of you have been watching at least some of the Olympics in the last 2 weeks. And there's been some good jokes on the internet about funny sports that should have been introduced.
Don't the balloon touch the floor. Speed texting.
Unfortunately, there was an actual competition for this in the US. Have you ever watched the actual competitions and think, how did that become an Olympic sport? Everybody likes to make fun of synchronized swimming and the race walk, and rightfully so. But what about other less known odd sports of the Olympics, like hammer throwing? And other old-timers like pole vaulting and the triple jump? Yes, these take muscle and skill, but when will you ever need to do this in real life? This week, my buddy and I decided to take part in another sport that I think should be in the Olympics. Billiards trick shots. Though I don't think we're quite Olympic material yet, I'd like to give you a sneak peek on our tryouts. I know some people are very proud of the weird talents they have. And our culture even celebrates things like singing and sports above other things. And it makes me wonder, what is truly valuable and worth celebrating or competing over? The Bible says in 1 Timothy 4:8, physical training is of some value, but godliness has value for all things, for both this life and the life to come. But even among believers, we sometimes celebrate the wrong things. In Luke 10, after the 72 returned to Jesus after being sent out, they celebrated the power they had over the demons in Jesus' name. Someone even reported to me something similar to this past month. And to this Jesus said, "Do not rejoice that the spirits submit to you, but rejoice that your names are written in heaven." 1 Corinthians 13, 1-3 lists many things that believers want to excel at, but concludes that if we don't have love, we're nothing. I don't know what kinds of talents or gifts God has blessed you with, but I hope you don't miss the one thing that really matters: knowing God and making Him known. Wait, that's two. Paul writes about his desire and pursuit of this in 1 Corinthians 9:25. Everyone who competes in the games goes into strict training. They do it to get a crown that will not last, but we do it to get a crown that will last forever. Don't let the world define what is valuable and worth celebrating in your life. Pursue God and let Him be enough. Our relationship with Jesus and the others we connect Him with is all we can take to heaven. Let me close by saying, though, that I do think they should bring croquet back to the Olympics. I'll talk to you guys next time.